Hi, welcome to NetSet OS. Today we will discuss how we can search an element in list of number. There are two searching techniques. First is linear search and the second is binary search. For binary search, I have already made a video which is applicable if we got sorted elements in our list. Now, in this video, we'll be discussing about linear search. Linear search is also known as sequential search. It sequentially checks each element of list until a match is found. Here, whole list is searched throughout the process. So, in linear search, it will compare the element with each of element of the list sequentially. So, for this, first we need to start from leftmost part of the list. Need to check each element of list with a searched element. Here, the searched element is 54. So, we will start with leftmost element, which is 7. Then we will check whether the searched element is equal to 7. So we will check if 7 is equal to 54. It's not. So it will return false here. As it is running sequentially, it will check for first index 19. If 19 is equal to 54, here also it is not. It will return false here itself. Then it will check for 43. 43 is not equal to 54. Then it will check for 5. 5 is also not equal to 54. Then it will check for fourth index 54. Is 54 is equal to searched element, which is also 54. Now this time it will return true. Or either if you want the index from the list, you can return the index. So let's write program for it. So for this, I'll go to PyCharm. Here I have already made a Python file with the name search_number_list. So I'll start with writing the function def. As we are performing searching, so I'll write function name as search. Here in input, I'll give the searched element, so I'll define it as le. But before that, we need a list where we need to perform this searching function. So I'll write list1 and the element which need to be searched. So I'll write ele. Now we need to search each and every element of the list. So here we need a for loop. So I'll write for I in range, the length of list 1. With this for loop, it will search each and every element of the list sequentially. Then we will check which element is equal to list 1 I for ith index. If it is equal, it will return print element is found at index I, and here the loop will break. But what if the element is not found in this list? So it will return false and it will be in else part. We can either return false, or if we want in string language, we can say element is not found. So I'll write print element is not found in the list. Here I have used this break term so as to come out of the loop. For example, if we have a list of number, let's say 19, 4, 7, 55, 8, in our list. And I want to search for 7, or rather I can say my searched element is 19. So I have applied a for loop for it, and I'll check for each and every element in the list. So first I'll check the element 19 in the list 1, whether 19 is equal to 19. Yes, so here we got this searched element in the first iteration itself. But here we have applied a for loop from 0 to length of this list. That means till n. So it will walk through for each and every element. First for 0, then for 1, then for 2, then for 3, and till n. But here I got my element in the first iteration. I don't want that this loop should work till n times. So I applied here break, so that when I get this element at the first iteration, or if I have given the element as 7 and I get the index as 2, so that it will run just for 0, 1 and 2 times. It should not run for the entire loop. So I'll write break, so that the loop will break here itself and should come out of the loop and give the answer. So this is a benefit of break statement, which terminates the loop then and there itself. So this was the concept of break statement. Now after this, I have applied else statement. For else statement, let's say I have a loop 19, 18, 1, 7, 6. I'll not take more of the elements, just 5 elements in my list, and I want my element to be, let's say, 14, which is not in the entire list. So here we have used else part, so that if element is not found, as 14 is not found throughout our list, it will come out of the loop and will execute this else statement and will print element is not found in the list. So here I have used break statement, so that if I found, for example, it's 18, if searched element is found in this list, will start with first with 19, then with 18. So as soon as this 18 will be taken, it will come out of this for loop and directly will be giving the output. Let's see by running the program. First, I need to give a list. Let's say 13, 15. It will be random numbers. 6, 45, 76. And le will be, let's say, 6. And we need to call the function search, where we have list 1 and le, and we will print this function. So let's see, when I remove this break statement, what will happen. So I am removing this break statement and will run the program. Here I got element is found at index 3, but also it executed this else statement. But I don't want that. I want, as soon as this element is found in the entire list, it should come out of the loop directly and should not execute this statement, which is in else. So I'll write break statement and will run the program. Here I got element is found at index 3. So this is what I want. Now what if I have duplicate elements? Let's say here we have 3, one more 3, and let's increase the numbers in the list, 81 and then 3. We have 3 digit 3 times. So for this, we will make some changes in the program. Here I'll write a empty list. List2 is equal to empty array. Then I'll define the flag which is false. And as soon as this element will be found out in this list, flag will turn to true and this list 2 will be appending the index which is being duplicated. Then we will check if flag is equal to true. Here we will apply for I in list 2 and will print element is found at index I. So each time it will get the element, it will print element is found at index at such index. And then we will give else statement the same, print searched element is not found. Now I want to search for 3. I'll make change here to 3 and will run the program. Here I got element is found at index 2, 5 and 8. So here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we got at 2nd, 5th and 8th index. Now here I don't want this element to be hard coded. I want here element should be given by the user itself. So I'll write input, enter the number as it is entered by the user itself. So I'll use this input function and I also want this number specifically to be an integer. So I'll type cast into int. Now let's run the program. It is asking for enter the number. I'll write 3. I got the element is found at 2, 5 and 8 index. Let's make few changes. Here I'll write element is found at index I. So when I run the program, here it is asking for the number. So I'll write 3 and here it is saying element 3 is found at index 2, 5 and 8. Now let's search for 15. So I'll give 15 and here I got 15 is available at index 1. Now let's see for the number which is not there. So I'll enter the number as 88. When I press enter, here it says searched element is not found. Now if we talk about time complexity, it will be order of n as it is searching for each and every element. If I have searched for 3, it will visit each and every element of the list and will walk through the entire list. So time complexity will be order of n. And if we talk about space complexity, it hasn't used any additional space, so it will be order of 1. And you want to search the element in the sorted list, you can go for binary search. Binary search takes the complexity order of log n. But it has the limitation that it only works on the sorted elements. So this is it for now. If you want to know about binary search, I have also made a video on binary search. Link is in the description below. So please like my video and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.